Hello everybody, welcome, it's JK Slay here, welcome to my channel. Not only that, welcome to Outriders, the new game that just came out not that long ago, just a couple days, and ever since it has dropped, it's been causing a big stir in the gaming community, whether to buy it, whether not to buy it, whether to get it, whether to get it, as soon as they finish the bugs and whatever. I'm not gonna deny, you know, every game now has bugs. I haven't came across any bugs in game so far. The servers have been a little wacky, but guys, the game, no doubt, the story mode for this game, guys, is crazy. The gear for it, it is crazy. The story mode, I haven't beat the story mode yet, but I've been so involved in it, taking my time because it's so much fun, and the story is very good. Now, from people are wondering what type of builds you can make, guys. I'm gonna show you what end game can possibly be. I'm not even there yet, but I'm ecstatic. I'm excited to see what this will look like, and I'll tell you guys. I got my money's worth, and I'm not even done with the story yet. But I just want to go show you some of the talents that are in the game that you could use, as you see right here. Look, stand tall, receive anomaly power and fire power when out of cover for more than 5 seconds. Critical shot builds build up a 5 second stack affecting your anomaly power and your fire power. So basically, you crit more, you're going to end up with more skill power, more damage. Increase assault weapon damage by 10%. That's thrown on there just because I use the assault rifles, LMGs. Fresh mag, reloading increase your fire power by a certain amount for 8 seconds, grant you 15% bonus to close range weapon damage. Another mod, this one I have on there, phantom dash. So instead of rolling, guys, you could phantom dash. And then the other mod I have, killing shots, increase your firepower by 932, stacks up 3 times and deteriorates every 10 seconds. So every time I get a killing blow, guys, I'll be doing that much more damage, which is really cool. And all the gear looks amazing. I mean, look, you could switch up the mask real quick. Look at that. You could, and not only that, guys, you could throw the mods on there. And the killing enemies afflicted with burn increases your armor by 6,000 for 8 seconds, stacks up 3 times. Those are really cool talents. Those are really cool mods that you could switch around, make some really cool different build with, guys. I mean, the weapons are ridiculous, guys. I mean, I just found this one yesterday, Blightbearer. It is crazy. It is good. When you get a critical hit, toxic splurts out everywhere to everybody in 5 meters, does damage. Badass looking weapon, cool weapon, like it right there. All the weapons look ridiculous. I mean, this weapon so far ends up doing very good damage. I wouldn't say it's the best weapon right here, the Grim Arrow. This weapon right here ended up doing some more damage for me. The Thunderbird, very good weapon. Oh, look, Ultimate Storm Whip. Shots bring down lightning on an enemy, dealing 6,513 damage every second, guys. Every second. And then shots regenerate your health every second. So basically, that's what that weapon could bring you right there. But obviously, you got, guys, you could switch the mods up on it. That's not it right there. Let me just show you what the other outcomes are right here. So you get, just in case you guys are wondering, you haven't gotten the game yet, wondering, should I get it, don't know what the game's gonna be like. Look, you wanna take this piece of gear right here, the chest piece, let's see, take it. The attributes, max health, cooldown reduction, and healing received from heals. We could mod the gear, switch the mods on it, guys. Look, these are the tier 1 mods. So these mods right here basically just revolve around your skills. Whether you want to do more damage with your skills, this damage, when I use this, it inflicts bleed on enemies. The skill can be activated more than one time. So you could use the skill a couple times, boom, 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 increase the skill's base damage. Damaging enemies with the skill steals 33% of their armor. Effects last for 5 seconds, making you more tankier. Increase the skill's range by 60%. You want to hit more than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 guys, so be it. That's your build, let it be it. Grant you 5,000 points of armor for each enemy hit by the skill. Last 8 seconds, stacks up 10 times. You hit 10 enemies, that's like 40,000 extra armor right there, guys. That's a tank build, if you ask me. This right here, each enemy killed with this skill restores 10% of max health to all allies in a 20-meter radius around you. That's pretty good, if you ask me. So basically, just those, you could buff your skills up, increase the damage by a lot. But then you move on to tier 2 mods, and it just switches up the ball game. Using skills around enemies within just damages enemies. You ain't even got to hit them with the skill. Critical shots inflict bleed on bad guys. Killing enemies while they're afflicted with bleed increases your weapon leech by 40%. And for those who don't know, Weapon Leech is basically the more Weapon Leech, when you shoot the bad guy, you just get health back per bullet, which is very cool. You want to have a lot of Weapon Leech. A lot of different talents. You see, guys, I mean, this game is no bueno. It's a very good game. It's not, don't wait for them to fix things up, because you don't want to wait. You want to get it now. It's a very good game, and I haven't even gotten to the end game, guys, yet, and I heard about it, and I'm so hype to get there, because I know the end game is going to be, it's going to have an end game, guys. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. I've played a lot of looter shooters. I've played a lot of games that require end game content, and I got to tell you what I see right here in this game, guys. They pulled their weight, and it is going to be a fight to make a game that's better than this one this year. Like I said, there's a big fight between the community right now whether this game is the game. In my opinion, it is the game, guys. There's no other game right now to buy except for this one right here. And as you can see, there's tier 3 mods, talents, whatever you want to call them. And I didn't even unlock none of them, but a lot of them are going to be pretty badass, increasing your damage with your skills, increasing your damage with your weapons, and so on, increasing your armor, your health. I mean, guys, we got to all admit, the weapons, they do look pretty cool. And then you see, you switch up the weapons right here. Like, you could equip this weapon right here. You could raise the attributes. So I have 3 attributes right there. I could raise my crit damage. Look, it goes from 21.7, 23.3, 25. All right. 26.6. See, upgrade that. Close range damage, 8.67, 9.1. 9.34, guys, you see how that's going, and so on. And then, as you're leveling up your world tier, you know, you don't want your weapons to fall behind. If you really like the weapon, you don't have to get rid of it, like most games, stash, throw it away. Nah, this game's a little different. Current maximum weapon level, right now it could be 38. Once I bump that up, it could be 39, increase that, it'll increase my mods, it'll increase my firepower, increase my damage, just because I like that gun. I like it, I don't want to get rid of it. I don't have to. That's the good thing about this game. You go farm for extra gear. You go farm for extra mods. You go farm for resources. You farm for new banners like this, and different parts of the vehicle. Guys, the game, like I said, it's no bueno. It's an amazing game. And right now, for people that are not playing this game, they're really missing out on a good opportunity right here. And each class is 4 classes, 8 skills. And yeah, you might say, oh, only 8 skills, but it's not the 8 skills. It's depending on how you use those 8 skills, because those 8 skills can be used in different ways to maximize your build, to maximize your DPS, to perform better, to increase your armor, to stay alive, basically. And then these are the class points right here. Crazy, guys, crazy. Increase your close range weapon damage. I mean, a lot of good points that are very cool. Very, very cool, guys. Like I said, I played looter shooters. I've played end game content games, and this game right here is pulling its weight in the gaming community right now. If you haven't gotten it, you should try it. Download the demo, try it out. If you like it, download it, guys, please, because we need more players. Big multiplayer game looking. It's new, looking for new players, especially for the end game. Can't wait to run into some of you guys in the multiplayer. Hope you guys get the game and enjoy it just as much as I am. Peace out, guys.